I just bought the best V8 truck ever made. It's not any of these new Tundras. They don't even have a V8 anymore. And it's not this old Ford. I couldn't even get the dang hood open. And it's definitely not one of these overpriced new trucks that I've been talking about for the past year. In my last video, I showed you three old V8 trucks and said I was gonna buy one of them. A green Eddie Bauer Ford F-150, a white 2002 Toyota Tundra, and a first generation Ford F-150 Raptor. And in today's video, I'm gonna show you which truck I bought and exactly why. Before I show you what I bought, we need to talk about what I think is the worst thing that's happening with new trucks right now. What made me buy an older V8 truck and why you might want to do the same thing as well. Over the past few years, V8 trucks have been slowly getting killed by woke California and the US government. Ford has the EcoBoost V6, Toyota is pushing their hybrid turbo engines, and Ram just revealed that 2024 could be the last year for the V8 TRX. While V6 turbo engines may be more fuel efficient and lighter, there's a few things that make them worse than the V8 engines they're replacing. Turbo engines are less reliable, harder to work on, and sound absolutely terrible. This is what a V8 sounds like. And this is a turbo V6. Not to mention, new trucks are ridiculously overpriced. And that's why I ended up buying the truck that I'm sitting in right now. This 2002 Toyota Tundra that I paid $10,500 for. And over the next few weeks, I'm gonna be dumping a few thousand dollars into some mods that I think will make it just as good, if not better, than some of those $65,000 plus new trucks that you see today. But first, I need to show you some of the good things about this old Tundra, and also some of the bad. And we're here in my garage because I'm also gonna be doing some of the first mods to this truck that I have sitting on this table, and a few things on this truck that we're gonna remove that will make it even more awesome from day one. Now let's get into some of the good things, some of the bad things, and the first few mods on this 2002 V8 Toyota Tundra TRD Off-Road. Now let's go ahead and start with the good stuff. And for that, I'll need the key. Unlock it, open the door, step inside this luxurious cabin of a truck from 2002, put the key right in the ignition, and start it up. Oh yeah, it's old Toyota for you. Starts every time. This is Toyota's super reliable 4.7 liter V8 engine that if you do proper maintenance and take care of it, this thing has been known to last over 1 million miles. So that's good thing number one. The good thing number two about this truck is right here on the frame, and it's something that everyone who was watching my previous video when I was searching for the truck made a comment about. That is this frame here. And as you can see, I've wiped all the dirt off from this section here, and it is very, very clean, because one of the points that people were making is these early frames were prone to rusting and there was a recall and some entire frames had to be taken care of. But I looked it up and this one was already sprayed with the anti-corrosion stuff that Toyota did. And as you can see right here, the frame is pretty, pretty clean. And this was just a basic spray with just a little bit of water. And if you look underneath here at a part that I didn't clean and the underside of the truck, with a little bit of wash, it'll look practically brand new. Good thing number three is the interior. This was really well taken care of, and despite the mats being a little bit dirty, if you pull this carpet up, it looks almost brand new underneath. There are no cracks or anything in the dash. The radio has already been upgraded with a new version that's Apple CarPlay compatible, and the back is just as immaculate, if not even better than the front. Good thing number four is just a quick one, is that this was a one owner, well-maintained vehicle, so when you look at the Carfax, it's pretty much flawless with all of the maintenance records you could ever want. Good thing number five, it's limited with the TRD off-road package. And good thing number six, obviously, is that it was super cheap. Now let me get to the bad stuff, because when you buy an old truck, there's always gonna be a few issues. This first thing's not necessarily bad, it's just something that I don't like. That is this bug guard slash deflector right here. While it does keep the hood from getting rock chips along this section, it really does nothing to keep rock chips from getting on the windshield, as you see here and here. And there's also some spots over here. Plus, it just doesn't look good, and it just ruins the clean look of the body lines of this truck. The second problem is down here. These are the original BFG all-terrain tires. Not that were originally on this truck, but the first all-terrain tire that BFG made. And as you can see, they're pretty worn down. They're dry rotted with cracks all across it, and they're just not safe. The third thing that's bad, number three, these side steps. I don't really like them. I think they're unnecessary. This is an older truck. It doesn't sit as high as some of the new ones, as you can see. But one of the things we're installing is a leveling kit to raise it up and make room for those 33-inch tires. But we're going to take that off because I just don't like it. It's unnecessary, and I tend to just step over it when I'm getting in the truck anyways. And one of the last things that's not too great, these side trim pieces need to be replaced, but they're really cheap. And I found a set for around $85. And then also another thing before I forget, this grill has some issues with the chrome kind of peeling, and you can hear that right there. So we need to replace this grill. And lastly, because I keep forgetting the bad things, the more I walk around it, the more bad stuff I see, which tends to happen with old stuff, the headlights. As you can see, they're pretty yellowed, they're faded. You can see where it's kind of a little bit clear at the top here where the sun hasn't hit it as much. And the corner markers have a bunch of water and moisture inside. We're gonna have to either replace these or clean these off, and these just need to be replaced or resealed to keep the moisture out. But the good thing is, I've got some stuff over here on this table that will take care of a lot of the bad stuff right now. Now, before I show you what's in this box right here, let's take this stupid bug deflector off. Let's remove these side pieces, and then I'll show you this cool thing that I have in this box. Now the screws are out, rip this stupid thing off, throw it in the pile, shut this gigantic hood. And look at that. Oh man, that looks so much better without this bug deflector on there. I'm gonna give the non-bug deflector front end one thumb up because my hand is holding the other. Next up, these side steps. And the side steps are gone. Look how much better this is already. Now that we've removed the bug shield on the front and we've removed the side steps, it actually looks a little bit higher than it did. Even though we didn't do anything, we just raised the profile just ever so slightly by removing the side steps, which were terrible. Now I've got one more thing, and it's in this box right here. Bet you didn't know we were gonna be doing an unboxing in this video. You thought it was just a truck reveal. In this box is something from a company called Taco Vinyl here in Boise, Idaho. They do a bunch of cool stuff for Toyotas. And I got, voila, TRD Pro Grill to go on the front to replace the aging front grill on this truck. And what's even cooler is I have this and these little screws, because in this package right here, you may see some colors underneath. It's something to give the white and black just a little bit of accent that I think will really set off the front end, despite the faded headlights, which we'll fix later. So this will go right around here in this spot. And as you can see, just makes it stand out a little bit more. Let's throw it on here real quick. So we'll go from this old looking chrome and black grill that's faded and busting up and the chrome is falling apart here. And we'll modernize that just a little bit. I've got all these nuts that came off the grill off of these little spots right here, including the two bolts that hold on the hood release here. So we're gonna throw this on. So all we gotta do is pull this off of here. There's the old crusty grill with all the mess. And this new Toyota TRD Pro grill comes with new bolts for the back that go in this section. So all I have left to do is put those in there. We'll throw this in and see what it looks like. All right, so we just rest this new grill in the same holes as the old grill. And we reuse the old nuts. And here's the big reveal. Brand new TRD Pro Toyota grill on a 2002 Toyota Tundra. I don't know about you, but I think it looks really, really good. Just tell me in the comments. So we got the first few mods already done on the 2002 V8 Toyota Tundra. For a little recap, we removed the ugly bug deflector. We took off the side steps that are pretty much useless when the truck is not really that high to begin with. And for the finale, we put the new TRD Pro grill on the 2002 Toyota Tundra. And I think it just makes the front end look a little bit better and kind of brings it into a bit more modern times and makes it look a little bit newer. Now, before we go, I want to talk about why I didn't buy the first gen Raptor or the green Eddie Bauer Edition F-150. And there's some really easy ways to explain why. The Eddie Bauer F-150 was not four wheel drive, that was two wheel drive. I would like four wheel drive because I want to do some fun stuff with this Tundra. And honestly, if you're gonna have a truck, I feel like it just needs to be four-wheel drive anyways, because it's better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have four-wheel drive. But as far as that blue first-gen Raptor goes, it just has a lot done to it already. It had bumpers, it had some nice tires and wheels on it. You can't really do much other than maybe lift it a little bit higher, throw a supercharger on it, but that's all been done on YouTube before. And I just didn't want to go that route. I felt like it's been there, done that. And it was $28,000, $29,000. While this right here was $10,500, it was original, one owner, always been in Idaho. And I could just do way more to this Tundra than I could that Raptor, especially this being completely stock. So like I said, I've got big plans for this. I'm gonna show you how you can take a $10,000 truck and make it just as good, if not better, than some of these newer trucks that are costing $65,000, $75,000, even over $100,000. With just a little bit of budget for some modifications. As you can see, two of these things were free. The bug deflector removal cost nothing, the side steps cost nothing, and this grill right here was only about $225, which is not that bad at all for a brand new front grill that replaces the old one that was clearly falling apart. If you want to keep up with all the videos in the cheap V8 truck series, or if you just want to see any of my other videos where I talk about cars, the car market, and just do a lot of fun stuff in general, we're definitely going to hoon this truck a little bit on some off-roading, possibly even jump it with some of the things I have planned for the mods. Make sure you subscribe, hit like on this video, and I'll see you in the next video. I also forgot another thing I hate about it, and that's bad, is the seatbelt. It doesn't retract unless you do this. Anyways, that's it. Subscribe, and I'll see you tomorrow.